state of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم at one point and how it changed. It did not stay the same. You see the change that we were talking between the brightness of the day and the darkness of the night and the change and the movement. The same thing is happening in the human life. And I want you also to reflect on your own life. Where were you 5 years from today? Where were you 10 years or 15 years or 20 years? And to see the changes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, didn't he find you an orphan and gave you a shelter? أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ So at one point you were an orphan. But you were not abandoned. You were not forsaken. But you were given a shelter. Is that right? Now the same thing. وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًا فَهَدَى You were thinking and you were lost. You want to do something about the situation, okay? And that state did not continue because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the guidance. Fahada gave you the guidance. So you are not lost anymore. وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى And you were poor. And then he enriched you. Or you became you were freed from the prison of poverty or asking others for help. So you see the state of being, what were you now? To the state of becoming, where you like to see yourself. Don't lose hope. Just look back at your own history and you will see the evidence for the change that is really coming.
It's very interesting, beautiful, because again, the Quran is introducing these very deep and abstract ideas, but at the same time use the images. The structure, the images, the language, every possible tool so they can convey the message to a very large, if you like, audience. And here, because when you are in desperate situation and in when there is a lot of pressure under you, to find a way to escape that situation, usually it's anything that comes, you know, to your hand or to your mind, or you'll just grasp it because you are under that pressure that things will save you. And sometimes you even doubt that possibility you can escape that situation. So Quran is giving very, very beautiful images here. لَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فآوى. So yatim is orphan, but we call in Arabic yatim someone who lost, you know, his father and mother, if you like, but not at any stage in his life. When he was, you know, baby, if you like. It means, what does it mean? So it means he lost his parents, but it was the people they are very close to him that can protect him. Because right now I lost my father and mother, عليهم رحمة الله, but no one will call me yatim, you know, because you have that ability to protect, if you like, yourself or to make your life possible. So if we take in that situation, also any one of us also was born in the situation of powerless. You were not able when you were born to protect yourself. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us that protection, that make our life where we are today possible through that powerless situation. So why we need to doubt it when we are in this possible, this better situation that we can find a solution for harsh moment. This is very, very, very good analogy. Because we can find ourselves in very powerless situation and time. But this should also remind us that yes, we were in that situation
before.
This is deja vu type of things. This happened before. So why we need to doubt there is still hope? Because we really, all of us came from that situation. So that very, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is here, is to guide us, to help us. And He gave us also, He taught us the way how we can make that happen in our life. So this is also, we should never doubt it, because we already have it and we saw it before. أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَهَدَى وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًّا فَهَدَى. And this is very, very interesting how the Quran defined ضَال. So that is the meaning also when you don't know where to go. You are lost. ضَال, it means, it doesn't mean the Prophet or anyone was doing wrongdoing. But ضَال, you lost the reference. You lost the guidance. That is really a time when you don't have a reference to know, to locate yourself at space and time so you can continue your journey and giving meaning to your life. So this is why you need the reference to fight a dhalal. Because there is no meaning how closer you are to your goal if you don't have that awareness and you don't know it. But how you can know it without map, without reference, without that ability to see where you are? You see when you are on the trip, sometimes you go to the rest area, you go to the map, and the map will be very helpful when you have that small circle to say, you are here. That things really help you a lot to know where you are and how you can continue your journey. The map, they never help you if you don't have that small, you know, how small the information is, but it's very, very helpful. So dhal here is defined toward the reference. You need the reference. You need Al-Quran in your life in order to fight al-dhalal. Don't say, hey, I don't need it, I'm very close. There's no such thing. The same thing, this is why also they distinguish between what we call applied mathematics and non-applied mathematics. Applied mathematics is mathematics when the universe was present, when human being built it. So it means when you ask the universe, you still have an answer. Non-applied mathematics, even if it's mathematics, there is no answer to it. Because the universe, the reference was not there. When you make it happen, if you may. So it's the applied, it also has that meaning. It has an answer. You get the answer you want, if you like. Still, there's an answer. But if there is no, the reference is not there, don't look for that. And it's very interesting to see a dhalal connected to the reference, not what you were doing as bad or good. Because bad or good will be defined also according to the reference. There's no such thing bad in itself or good in itself. But the reference right now will give the meaning to it and make from it wrong direction or good direction. And this is very, very interesting too. يَجِدْكَ ضَالًا فَهَدَى وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى. Also the other image. And عَائِلًا is the word also. Is not that in need, but عائلة also in Arabic is the same origin, family. But يعولو, you know, it's to give, to help other. But it means there's a lot of people around you
to take care of.
Help, you know, asking for help. Or you have that responsibility to help them. And أغنى, Quran will use أغنى and it does not use استغنى. We talked about استغنى before. استغنى is so that have that wrong feeling that you are not in need to others.